How do we know when someone or something touches us? After all, how do we feel or sense things around us? From small ages, you must have been hearing that skin is a sense organ. After all, what happens in skin so that we are able to feel those kind and those unfortunate unkind touch? So today, let's have a peep into this. The skin that we see has two layers, the upper epidermis and the lower dermis. Widely distributed in these layers are certain small structures that reach maximum up to 2 mm into 1 mm size. These are called the sensory receptors, those receiving the sensory stimulation. All of you may have heard that all the information to the brain is carried by nerves from different parts of our body. Well, this ain't any different. The so-called sensory receptors are actually specialized nerve endings in our skin that can detect touch, pressure, pain, heat, cold, and many more. Sensory receptors are modified nerve endings surrounded by some connective tissue. These nerves are nothing but just cells. In our body, all the cells contain membrane, and all these membranes contain some charges across them, the same old positive and negative. This charge across the membrane is due to the difference in the concentration of the ions inside and outside the cells. When different kinds of stimulus are applied on these receptors, there is deformation of the receptors. This deformation causes certain ion channels in the membrane of the nerve cells to open. Ion channels, as they sound, allow the transmission of different ions, for example, sodium, potassium, across the membrane. The above process can be summarized as, when a stimulus is applied, there was opening of the ion channels, and this resulted in change in membrane permeability of the nerve endings, thereby facilitating movement of ions across the membrane, and a membrane potential was generated. Now, this electric potential generated in the nerve ending inside the receptor is called receptor potential. As the stimulus strength increases, the amplitude of the receptor potential also increases. Attached to the receptor is a sensory nerve, and that same sensory nerve ending is modified to form the receptor. This modified nerve ending has receptor potential in it now. Now, this electric potential is to be transmitted to the part of the sensory nerve that is not modified. Okay, let's consider you are lighting a firecracker. Maybe when you try with the first match, it may not get lighted. But you could understand that beyond a certain limit, the cracker gets fired. Similarly, when the receptor potential, that is the electric potential in the receptor, reaches at or above a threshold value, an action potential can be generated in the adjoining nerve. In our body, we have receptors that mediate response to touch, pressure, compression, stretching, etc. And these are called the mechanoreceptors. There are different kinds of mechanoreceptors. Namely, they are the Meissner corpuscles, Merkel cells, Ruffini corpuscle, and the Pacinian corpuscle. They respond to different kinds of mechanical stimuli like sustained pressure, touch, slow vibrations, etc. When we touch an object, one or more of the receptors gets activated simultaneously, producing sensation of contact with that object. As a response to these mechanical changes, corresponding ionic changes takes place in the receptor and an electrical impulse is produced. This electrical impulse, if strong enough, produces an action potential in the nerve which is attached to the receptor, and it propagates to the spinal cord and then to the brain. Stronger the amplitude of the receptor potential, greater is the frequency of the action potential is produced, which we shall discuss later. Action potential is carried forward by the sensory nerves. Painful stimuli are sensed by certain receptors called nociceptors. Now let's see what produces pain. Strong pressure, example by a sharp object, extremes of temperature, which is 45 degrees or more, or maybe combinations of these and many more can produce pain. There are different receptors for sensing heat, cold, or acid-related pain. Do you know even itch is related to pain sensation? Pain is a whole big topic which we will deal in a separate video. Did you know that there are even pain physicians who specialize in relieving pain, especially in terminally ill cancer patients? Those receptors that respond to the warmth and cold are called the thermoreceptors. There are specific cold and heat sensitive areas on our skin. As the temperature falls below 40 degrees Celsius, they start to fire slowly and increases as they approach 24 degrees Celsius. After that, it decreases and temperatures below 10 degrees Celsius can give a local anesthetic effect. When skin temperature reaches more than 39 degrees Celsius, the heat sensitive receptors starts to fire. And when temperature rises above 45 degrees Celsius, it will induce pain. When we eat something from our favorite restaurant or anywhere, we feel it is tasty. When we walk past a public latrine, especially in India, we feel the sting, right? Those receptors that respond to change in chemical composition of our surrounding environment are called the chemoreceptors. Some relatable examples of these are receptors that detect taste in the mouth, smell in the nose, oxygen level in the arterial blood, osmolality of the body fluids, carbon dioxide concentration, and other factors that make up the chemistry of our body. As mentioned earlier, there are acid-sensing ion channels that are activated by pH change and are responsible for acid-induced pain. Now, you must have understood there are different kinds of receptors in our body and they all have differential sensitivity. How do two types of sensory receptors detect different types of sensory stimuli? That is, each type of receptor is highly sensitive to one type of stimulus for which it is designed, and yet is almost non-responsive to other types of sensory stimuli. Interesting, right? We would see more about this in our next video. If you have any queries about the settings, please feel free to ask in the comment section below. Thank you.